What if I told you that there was a way to customize your motion graphics templates to your own branding before you even bring it into Premiere Pro, so you don't always have to make those changes over and over again? Well, that's what I'm gonna show you how to do in today's video. Let's get into it. Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to take a MoGrit file, a motion graphics template, open it up inside of After Effects, make customizations to that, and then export it to Premiere Pro so that way it could live inside of your central graphics panel forever. So you can just drag and drop it and you don't have to redo those changes every time. Now, while templates are great and all because you don't have to do the animations, it is a pain to have to update the font, update the color each time you drag and drop it. So there's a way to work around this. Now, this particular pack that I'm modifying is from Envato Elements. And if you guys don't know what Envato Elements is, it's a great creative marketplace where you can subscribe monthly or annually to download unlimited number of video editing templates, whether it's motion graphics templates, titles, logo reveals, or transitions. It also has stock video and it has graphics templates as well. And right now there is a limited time sale for Cyber Monday with Envato Elements, 40% off lifetime. And what that means is you can get 40% off monthly plan or an annual plan forever. So every time you renew, that 40% carries over. Now, if you miss this sale, of course, you can use my link below to get 70% off your first month. So there's still a discount available. All right. So thank you so much to Envato Elements for sponsoring. And without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into After Effects. So here I have the lower third template that I have chosen that I will be using for this tutorial. I've already downloaded it, and normally you would just import these MoGrits in Premiere Pro. So let me take this downloaded folder. You can see all of the minimal titles here as MoGrit files. Normally you would just take all of them by holding shift and then importing them into the Essential Graphics panel here, which you would then find them by going down here. And notice they all import as black, which, you know, isn't ideal. You want to see a preview of them, but you would essentially drag and drop this into the timeline and then you would see it here, right? Now you can, you know, reduce the scale and you can change the position. And then you would just update the shape color. You would have to update the logo, the font. You would have to do this each time you drag it in to the Premiere Pro timeline. So let's say you want to use this title every time, but you don't want to update the colors and make all the changes every single time you drag it into the timeline. So this is where you can now open up MoGrit files inside of After Effects. Before, there was some weird workaround where you had to .zip and unzip the file to be able to open it in After Effects, but this is why you need to update to the latest version of After Effects 2022, so that way you can do this. So first you need to go to After Effects, and then you're gonna go up to File, Open Project, and this is where you can now open up a MoGrit file. Before, you could not do this, so select title, whichever title you want to edit. I'm going to use title 5 and then hit open. And then it will ask you to extract this MoGrit file. So you can save this anywhere. I'm just going to call this new title and save it in my project folder and select extract. And then I will basically extract this MoGrit, and you can see from Essential Graphics, there's all of these parameters that allowed us to customize the MoGrit in Premiere Pro, and this is where it was built in After Effects. And if you're working from an After Effects template that doesn't have the Essential Graphics panel, all the parameters there, you can watch this tutorial right up here, and I can show you how to actually put the parameters into the Essential Graphics to make it into a MoGrit from the get-go. If you don't have the Essential Graphics open, go up to Window, Essential Graphics. And from here, we can make customizations. So for example, instead of the Envato logo, let's say you want it to be a headshot. So you can right click on this here and reveal in timeline. And you can double click on this comp here. And this is the actual Envato file. I'm going to replace this with my headshot. So let me find my headshot here. It's inside of my project file. And I'll drag this into the project panel here and drag it into the comp. And then I will press S on my keyboard to scale this up. There we go. Press P to move it left and right and up and down. And let's see how this looks by going back to the titles comp here. And we can get a preview. Let's fit it to frame so we can see it better. And that's looking pretty good. Now we just need to update the colors and the content to always match what I want it to be when I use this particular title. So for the colors here, I'm actually going to go to my libraries because I have my color theme saved in my library. And let's go back here, go to my library, and let's go to my Gal theme. Here it is. So I'm going to right click get info, and then I can use this dropper tool to select this yellow color. And since I don't want it to be a gradient, I'm going to select this other dropper and make it a solid yellow. And then for the content here, I'm going to change this to my first name, Kelsey. And instead of it, I like the Montserrat already, but instead of it being blue, I think I'm going to make this just white. But remember, it's a motion graphics template, so if I change my mind, I can always change that in Premiere Pro later. But this is just getting us started here. And user friendly, I'm going to change this to my handle, Premiere_Gal. That's my Twitter and Instagram handle, so you can follow me there. And instead of black italic, let's use bold italic. And let's make this a little bit smaller. So after I made this smaller, I want to change the position of the text, but there's no parameter here for me to do that. There's just the composition position and the composition scale, which controls the entire graphic. So here's a cool tip. If you double click on this parameter here, just in the empty space here, it'll take you to this particular text inside of the comp. And here you can press P to go to position, and I can drag this position underneath this parameter. And now going back to the titles comp, which is our main comp here, we can then use this control to move it over to the left and to the right. So we can bring this up a little bit and down until it looks right. So you can add these parameters in here. And if you want to learn more about how to add these parameters, again, you can watch my full series on how to, create your own motion graphics templates or take an After Effects template and turn it into a MoGrid file. So this is looking pretty good. One more thing that I want to change here is, let's say that, this is a 4K title, but if you're not going to edit in 4K and you don't always want to scale it down to 1080p, we can change this here. So what we can do is go to titles, go to composition settings, and here we can actually change this to 1920 by 1080. And this is 1080p resolution, and hit OK. And notice how it crops it down. What we can do is we can, scale this back. So we can, underneath composition scale here, so we can scale this down, and then we can move it over. Let's say we always want the lower third to be on the lower right. We can, lower this down. So that way it's always going to be here in this position. And you'll notice it's a little lower res. That's because we're at a quarter resolution. So I can bring this back up to full and it will look super crispy now. So now we have our lower third here. And if you want to learn how to add sound effects to your MoGrid file, so every time you drag this lower third in Premiere Pro, it comes with a sound effect, you can watch this video up here. And the place that I get all of my sound effects and music for YouTube is Epidemic Sound. And actually right now, Epidemic set me up with a 90-day free coupon for you. Just enter in GALBF2021 at checkout and you can get 90 days free of sound effects and music. I also created my own Epidemic Sound playlist with all of my favorite lo-fi beats, as well as alternative tracks that are great for background music for your videos that I use in my videos. I think somebody commented on a video that I have very zen, chill music, and I love that type of music, and Epidemic has a great selection there. So go ahead and check that out. So now, how to export this? What we're going to do is, you can, first of all, you can change the name if you want something other than title 5. You can say, Gal lower third, just to make it more memorable. You can set the poster frame, which is something that the author of this pack didn't do. Remember Premiere Pro, it just had a bunch of black empty frames. So set that poster time so you can actually preview what it looks like, which is super helpful. And then down here, just export motion graphics template. And then it will ask you to save it. And now you're going to have a new window where you can choose where to save it. So you can save it to your local templates folder, which will make it appear automatically in Premiere Pro's Essential Graphics panel on the device that you're working on. But if you work on multiple devices, I recommend choosing My Library, because if you're signed into your Creative Cloud account, it'll appear on any device that you're on. You can also save it to the local drive if you need to send it to somebody else, like upload it to Google Drive. You can attach it that way. So I'm going to choose My Library because it's the safest, for me at least, and hit OK. Now, back in Premiere Pro, we can go to Browse. Well, we can delete the title we had before, and we can go to Browse, and I'm gonna choose Libraries, and this time, there it is, GAL Lower Third. I can see it right here, and drag and drop it into the timeline. And that's it. Now it's fully formatted to my style, and I don't have to make all those changes each time. Just drag and drop it, and it's there. So it's like a template already. But of course, if I need to make any changes, I can using these parameters. So you can do this exact same thing to any template from Envato Elements. And if you have any issues with any templates that you download, just leave a comment below, and I'd be happy to see how I can help you out. Thank you so much to Envato Elements for sponsoring today's video and providing all these templates as unlimited access to us creators. It's a great deal. Don't forget to take advantage of the Cyber Monday deal. If you miss it though, you can always get 70% off your first month using my link below. That's all for today's video. If it helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.